docentemente, como tú que tienes mente, cachetado fai soñar. Cuando guardas tu jardín, sientes y en este jurarancho, no profumo così fino, tinto cuore se ne va. E tu dici a patto addio, da lontano da sto cuore, della terra dell'amore, pieno cuore non torna.
Trovare parole nuove, l'astro d'argento, la ci dell'onda, prospero il vento, sul mare luccica, l'astro d'argento, la ci dell'onda, prospero il vento. Venni dell'agile, parchetta mia, Santa Lucia, Santa Lucia. Venni dell'agile, Santa Lucia. Sul mare l'astro d'argento, la ci dell'onda, prospero il vento. Venni dell'agile, parchetta mia, Santa Lucia.
Buonasera, I am Claudio De Vellis.
And I am Justine DeVito Tenney. We're thrilled to be here tonight to celebrate NOIAW's 40th anniversary on behalf of the Francesco and Mary Gimbelli Foundation and our co-director, Angelo Vivolo.
We extend our admiration and compliments to tonight's honorees, Brenda Vaccaro and Adriana Trigiani, Italian-American women who have achieved great success and are wonderful representatives of our culture. And to Angelo Vivolo, who was handpicked by Francesco and Mary Gimbelli to lead their foundation.
Congratulations to NOIAW on its 40th anniversary and to all of tonight's honorees.
Auguri. Kudos and congratulations to our sheroes for creating this organization and celebrating Italian American women. What a great idea. Grazie mille to Bani Mandina, my personal shiro, Aileen Riotto Sirey, Matilda Raffa Cuomo, Geraldine Ferraro, God rest her soul, Roseanne Colletti, and my heart, Donna De Matteo. Bravo, ti ringrazio for all you've done for NOIAW and for the community. And I would like to congratulate our esteemed honorees, Brenda Vaccaro, Angelo Vivolo, and especially the exceptionally gifted director, writer, storyteller, comedian, and my brilliant friend, Adriana Trigiani. Congratulations.
Congratulations to the National Organization of Italian American Women, its members, and especially its founders. I am Marion Pardo, president of the Columbus Citizens Foundation, and we are thrilled to support you in the celebration of the 40th year of your founding. Your honorees are emblematic of all you support, achievement by Italian Americans, and equal opportunity for all of us. Brenda Vaccaro's performances make our spirits soar. Adriana Trigiani's books inform our history and enrich our souls. Angelo Vivolo's works in the culinary world have nurtured and enlivened us all. We honor them for all of their careers, but even more for their dedication to philanthropy, especially within the Italian American community. The Columbus Citizens Foundation has for many years been the beneficiary of the generosity of our member Adriana and our past president Angelo. We thank them for always being there for us and honor them and Brenda today for all of their good work. Happy anniversary to NOIAW and all good wishes for continued success in the decades to come.
Consul General Fabrizio Di Michele.
Good morning to all of you. It is with great pleasure that I participate today in NOIAW's virtual 40th anniversary gala. Needless to say that I'd prefer to meet up in person all of you, but this I'm sure will come soon. Your organization embodies the spirit of Italian American women at its best, with a long and rich history and a bright future of opportunities ahead. Let me express my gratitude as Consul General of Italy in New York for the great efforts you constantly make to preserve the Italian heritage, promote cultural programs, create networking opportunities, and support young women through scholarships and mentoring. NOIAW represents more and more a true cultural bridge between the United States and Italy through the great network created by Italian-American successful women in every professional field. During the pandemic, you gave proof of great resilience and courage, being able to reinvent your programs digitally and reaching more and more people in the US, Italy, and also elsewhere. You can count on my personal support for your future activities, and you will be soon able to count on the first Italian woman ambassador of Italy to the United States, Mariangela Zappia. Let me finally warmly congratulate the three honorees who will be recognized today by your organization and praise the launch of the next 40 years fund. I wish happy anniversary to the National Organization of Italian American Women, and I look forward to seeing you all in person long before the 41st anniversary.
Monsignor Hilary Franco. I work at the Holy See Mission to the United Nations, and I would like to give you one word of encouragement. I would like to ask Almighty God to bless you in your extremely important work. The wonderful people that founded this organization. I would like to remember Geraldine Ferraro and all those who have been so active in the past. My friend, Maria Tamburri, I would like Almighty God to bless her in her incredible work for this organization. But the most important thing is to ask the blessing of the Almighty upon the future of the organization, and to carry on the great heritage that has been entrusted to us. Almighty God, bless us all. Bless all those who are celebrating this 40th anniversary of the gala. Bless those who have been instrument in getting this organization to reach this high level now and in the future. Amen.
Buonasera e benvenuti. Good evening and welcome. I am Pat Tinto, newly elected president of the National Board of NOIAW. Please join me in thanking Cristina for once again moving us with her gifted voice. And also, let's show our gratitude for the blessings from our dear friend, Monsignor Franco. And thank you also to our encouraging and supportive sponsors this evening for their advocacy and investment in our work. We appreciate you all. We have an amazing audience participating this evening from our community of over 5,000 women and men representing the world. This is such a special celebration for us, and we are honored to share with you all of the ways NOIAW has inspired, empowered, and connected Italian-American women over the last four decades. As a daughter of Italian-Americans, there were no female role models for me to follow into higher education. When I discovered NOIAW, I realized that there was a place for intelligent, professional, and career women to have a seat at the table and not just the one in the dining room for Sunday dinners. One of my most treasured memories was being invited to a casual dinner with some NOIAW members, including our founders, Dr. Aileen Riotto Sirey and Matilda Cuomo, three appellate justices, including the Chief Justice of the New York State Court of Appeals, the Superintendent of Financial Services for the State of New York, the New York City Commissioner of Aging, and of course, the inimitable restaurateur and chef, Lidia Bastianich. Reflecting on this organization's 40-year history, I realized that we were all about piercing the glass ceilings, as the late Congresswoman Jerry Ferraro did in 1984, becoming the first woman vice presidential candidate on a major party ticket. Following on her heels, Nancy Pelosi became the first woman speaker of the House of Representatives, and Rosa DeLauro recently became the first person from New England to chair the all-powerful Appropriations Committee. Without the cracks these Italian-American women made in that ceiling over the last four decades, there would not have been room for the first Italian-American to live in the White House, as we have now in Jill Giacoba Biden, our First Lady, nor another daughter of immigrants, Kamala Harris, to serve as the first woman vice president. Today, I am even more enthusiastic about the mission and our influence on the Italian-American female experience because of the plans we have over the next 40 years to enhance and expand the impact that we will make. We could not have had the influence we have had over the last 4 years without our founder, Dr. Aileen Sirey, and our honored board, founding members, and the dedicated leadership of current and past board members. Among those who have been a driving force in NOIAW's success is my friend and colleague, Maria Tamburri. Maria has been an inspiration to us all. In addition to her dedication to our organization and all things related to Italian culture, heritage, and the language, Maria is the ultimate role model for young Italian American women. She holds two master's degrees, one in international business and the other in educational counseling. She held seats on the boards of several nonprofit organizations in Florida, and then she joined NOIAW, becoming its executive director from 2008 and 2012. She was elected board president in 2014 and became chair of the National Board of Directors in 2015, where she leads the governance of our board as we carry out our strategy for growth. Maria has also become an exceptionally good friend, resource, and mentor to me. As I step into her former role as National Board President, I am so grateful to be her partner in this journey. Let's give a warm welcome to our National Board Chair, Maria Tamburri, as she shares her own reflections on NOIAW and to thank those that came before us.
Thank you, Pat. Good evening, everyone. I'm Maria Tamburri, Chair of the National Board of Directors. I've been a proud member of the National Organization of Italian American Women since 2006. It's really a pleasure to be with you as we finally celebrate our 40th anniversary. 15 months ago, the global spread of the coronavirus caused us all great concern. Like many other organizations, we faced the challenge of just how we would continue to realize our mission and serve our members during this very difficult time. Well, thanks to the creativity and dedication of our members and staff and the support of our board, we were able to pivot and transform our in-person programming into online broadcasts, which have given us a more national and global reach, going far beyond any previous expectations. Authorities on topics relevant to our members and community were featured and very well received. We are delighted that these virtual programs have touched literally thousands of people and sparked new relationships here and abroad. We thank this community for giving us the encouragement and confidence to find new ways to succeed. We consider actually this virtual gala tonight as a triumph of the new strategy. These efforts have been so successful that when the pandemic is behind us, we plan to offer both in-person and online programming as we go forward. We feel certain that our goal to grow and expand our organization will be realized. It is now my honor to introduce the co-chairs of our 40th anniversary virtual gala. Mrs. Matilda Raffa Cuomo is the former second and first lady of New York. She has dedicated her life to advocating for women, children, and families, and was the founder of Mentoring USA. She has received numerous awards for her work as an educator and was inducted into the National Women's Hall of Fame in 2017. We are proud to have her as a founding member of our organization and a director on our honorary board. Dr. Aileen Riotto Sirey is our other co-chair. Dr. Sirey founded the National Organization of Italian American Women in 1980. She served the organization for 32 years, first as the first president for 7 years, and then for 25 years as chairwoman. Dr. Sirey is currently a board member with the title Founder Chair Emerita. A retired psychotherapist, she is the recipient of numerous awards, including titles of Commendatore and Cavaliere from the Order of the Merit of the Republic of Italy. Dr. Sirey also served recently as the president of the Conference of Presidents of Major Italian American Organizations. She holds a distinction of being the first woman to hold this position. Dr. Sirey.
Welcome, everyone. I'm Dr. Aileen Riotto Sirey, and founder and chair emerita. And thank you, Maria, for the wonderful job you've done in leading us to this date and in the next 40 years. Has it really been 40 years? Wow. Thank you also to my founding members, and particularly Matilda Raffa Cuomo, former First Lady of New York State, who's been chairing this event as we share some of the memories of our NOIAW journal.
Thank you, Aileen, for your kind introduction. It is truly a pleasure to celebrate with so many friends the 40th anniversary of the National Organization of Italian American Women. Years ago, Geraldine Ferraro, Aileen Sirey, and I realized that American women of Italian descent really needed an organization of their own. And we came up with NOIA, the National Organization of Italian American Women. And it has accomplished so much good in the past 40 years. It will be exciting to witness its progress in the years to come. We're all looking forward to it. I applaud all of you and thank you for your dedication and enthusiasm through the years. And we must remember to continue with our slogan, Sempre Avanti.
Matilda, I remember the conversation that started this all. I approached Geraldine Ferraro after she was speaking on a panel. I introduced myself, we chatted a bit, and then I said, are there any organizations for Italian American women in the community? Her answer was, no, only men's and women's groups, where the men make the speeches and the women make the coffee. Then she said, why don't you start one? Surprised, I stood there with my mouth open, and she quickly said, why don't you come to Queens next week and we can talk about it? It was that spark of an idea that took off. And Matilda, I always think of you as our godmother since you named our organization. So to look back a little bit, our first meetings were always at the Columbus Citizens Foundation, where we had dinner and a speaker. Our very first speaker was opera singer Alicia Albanese. And through the years, we honored the best Italian and Italian-American women and men at our luncheons. In 1982, we had Marlo Thomas, Renee Taylor, and Joe Bologna. And at that first luncheon, we made Renee Taylor an honorary Italian. We had Kay Ballard, and after her run for vice president, Jerry Ferraro, with her mom and mother-in-law in this picture. At our 10th anniversary, we had the cast of Moonstruck at a dinner as honorees and with Olympia Dukakis. We honored directors, Lena Wertmuller, pictured here as well, and also from Italy, the Honorable Susanna Agnelli, and Rachel Ray, and Mother Angelica. We had another conference and luncheon to celebrate the 1992 quincentennial of Columbus, and we were delighted to have our three of the four congresswomen, Connie Morella, Susan Molinari, and Rosa DeLauro as our guests. In addition, we honored the first Italian-American woman astronaut. We honored Lidia and her family at a dinner for our 30th anniversary. But there are special places in my heart for some of our programs. I loved our exchange program, where we brought Italian college students to New York for 2 weeks. And the following year, sent Italian American students to Italy for 2 weeks. But most memorable for me were the wonderful trips we made to Italy. It was a positive way to connect with our past, seeing places that I know my peasant grandparents never saw. The most memorable, the largest, was in 1991 when we went to Friuli, Ancona, and Le Marche, and ended up in Rome, where 123 members had a private audience with the Pope in the inner sanctum of the Vatican. That was in 1991. This is all due to our friendship through the years with the wonderful Honorable Tina Anselmi, who happened to be the first woman minister in Italy. Our organization has been a dream for me. I don't think that I or any of our founding members realize the impact this idea would have on the Italian-American experience for women. Our community was yearning for this connection and to share the memories and stories of our Italian families. I even remember around Christmas, we had an event called Things Our Nonna Taught Us. We published a cookbook. We had an art show at Queens College. We did this with our programs and examined the values and attitudes of Italian Americans and how they are passed down from one generation to another with mother's milk. I think we also changed the perception of Italian American women. As I look back 40 years ago at some of the stereotypes, I know we made an impact. So I thank you again for being here in the beginning, Matilda, Donna DiMatteo, Bonnie Mandina, Roseanne Coletti, some of our founding members, and particularly my dear friend, Geraldine Ferraro, whom I miss very much. We built this organization with the help of the old timers like Barbara Gerard, Jan Zaro, Mary DiPiano Rothline, Angela Teasy, Donna DiMatteo, Maria Marinello, Joe Lero, Judge Mazzarelli, and Diana Femia, and all of those that are here today working with us right now. My heartfelt thanks to you. You've all been wonderful.
Good evening. I'm Mo Rocca, and I've always believed that everything happens for a reason. I'm a correspondent for CBS Sunday Morning, and I'm always looking for stories that will surprise and delight people. And when it comes to profiles, I want someone whom the audience will put their coffee mugs down for. I'm partial to legends. I like to remind people why they fell in love with that person in the first place. And so last year, I thought, Brenda Vaccaro's the ticket. Longtime fan here. She's always been compelling on screen, from her big screen debut in Midnight Cowboy, where she was swathed in that fox fur coat, to her fiery turn opposite Al Pacino, another paisan, in the Jack Kevorkian biopic on HBO. And Airport 77 is, of course, my favorite of the airport movies. It's the one where the plane goes underwater. And Brenda's funny as hell. Now, some actors are funny only in roles. I was convinced Brenda would be funny in person as well, a very different thing. But I didn't know where she was or if she'd even want to be profiled. Meanwhile, my partner Alberto was taking a writing class. One evening, he went off to see a reading of a new play by one of his classmates, Joy Behar, who happens to be Italian-American. When Alberto came back that night, he excitedly told me how none other than Brenda Vaccaro was in the reading and stole the show. Her timing, her inhabiting of the Italian-American mother role, her hair. He couldn't stop gushing about all of these things. The character, by the way, he said, kept criticizing people for things beyond their control. Example, another character who Brenda's character criticized for having teeth too big for her mouth. It's pretty funny. If that wasn't enough of a sign that I needed to get Brenda on our show stat, well, I called my producer, Jay Kernis. Jay agreed that Brenda would be a hit for us. He just needed a couple of days to track her down. Well, the very next night, I swear to you, I get an all caps text from, I'm at Cafe Luxembourg and Brenda Vaccaro is here and she's amazing. Yes, Jay had randomly run into her. The universe was affirming our instincts and telling us to kick it into high gear. A friend of mine once said that most celebrities, most famous actors, disappoint in real life. And it's true, but not Brenda. Maybe it's because when I finally did sit down with her, it wasn't like being with a celebrity. It was like being with an old friend. Maybe Brenda is so good at inhabiting other people because she knows herself so well. She knows who she is. She's the girl who was born in Brooklyn, the daughter of Italian immigrants, culinary pioneers who moved to Dallas, Texas in the 1940s when Brenda was just a kid to open one of the city's first Italian restaurant. She's the only child who would lie in bed listening to her extended family around the table late into the night on Sundays, talk and talk and laugh and reminisce, the nutcrackers getting full workouts. She's the teenager who by her own admission was trouble and was destined to return to New York at age 17, because the stage was where she belonged. Brenda has a sense of humor about life and about herself. In our interview, I loved how much joy Brenda got out of remembering comic Andrea Martin poking fun at her oh-so-breathy Tampax ad from the 1980s. Some actors are technically adept, even expert, at the externals, the accents, the mannerisms when they take on a character. But there's something missing behind the eyes. There's no pilot light. With Brenda, the pilot light never goes out. It's really more like a torch. It lights up everything around it. This woman is alive.
Let's see, what can I say about Italian heritage? Well, I had parents who had me earn my respect for it. Even though they came to this country by different means, to different places,
to begin life again, and to pave the way for me and for all other of my extended Italian family. And by extended family, I mean many an Italian presence. Yes, there are many. My father, who came to America, just like in The Godfather, named Mario Angelo Vivolo, on April 5th, 1911, and then applied for citizenship in America, July 1st, 1924. My mother came with her mother, three brothers, and two sisters. And then there were my father's sisters, brothers, mother, and father. Am I a proud Italian woman? Yes, I am. Because of the ladies in my family who reached out to me when I was young to preserve that heritage in me, to keep the heart, the love, warmth, and soul of the Italian woman, strong to survive and forever beautiful, to continue to give and preserve family and its daily practices of its culture. There was also its language, its food and cooking, and most important, its stories and pride of family and loyalty. And oh, did they sew? You bet they did. In order to survive in America, they started out with a sewing machine in a factory with a chair and the endless hours of work to earn a living. And so the best part? I will always remember I had my first costume made by my Aunt Mary in my first school play at the Ursuline Academy of the Nuns in Dallas, Texas. It was a blue satin dress with ribbons, handmade with her tiny little fingers and sewed carefully with a few beautiful beads here and there. And then Aunt Marge, who became a famous bridal designer for my lady bridals in New York City, who designed and made every opening night Broadway dress for me, my first wedding dress, and on and on and on. And oh yes, every muumuu I ever wore. And the cooking, oh please. I savored every meal they made, every bite memorable. And especially when Aunt Tessie made her bread pizza, and especially when Aunt Mary would ask me, "You want lenticchie with pasta?" What can I say? They made me who I am. Lessons well learned. The influence of my culture was well respected. My name is Brenda Buell Vaccaro, and every syllable means every day of my life. To be proud and grateful of this honor you bestow on me, and Aunt Mary, Aunt Tessie, Aunt Marge, Mario, my father, Christine, my mother, and 50 more devoted Italians also. Thank you. They deserve it.
He's out or keep them on?
Do you need them?
No.
Okay, take them out.
I want to make sure this is clean, this camera. Okay. All right. I know you've been talking this whole time and I couldn't hear you. Hello, everybody. I'm Mario Cantone, and I am so happy to be here for the 40th annual gala of the National Organization of Italian American Women. Being that I was brought up by a National Organization of Italian American Women, I think it's appropriate that I am here tonight. They reared me well, believe me. But the woman that I'm here to talk about and that you are honoring tonight is an Italian American woman that is probably my best friend in the world. To speak about her personally first, but of course you all know her as the novelist, the film director, even though she doesn't put this on her credit, the stand-up comedian, because she's hilarious. But when I met Adriana Trigiani years ago, I don't even know how long ago, it had to be more than 20, I knew instantly that this was family. It's that connection you get right away. It brings you back to your past, the family in your past. She is just someone that always made me laugh. She had my back 24/7. She was very strict with me. She was my mother, my sister, my mother, my sister, my mother, my sister. She's my mother and my sister. She really was. She, you know, because I can be a bad boy. And she's like, you're going to sit down and you're going to, if I disagree with her on something, if I, we see a play, oh, forget it. I loved it. How did you like that play? It was terrible. Yeah, she's very strict with me, but she's the most loving person in the world. If I need anything, I go to her. She has pretty much brought me up in my adult years. She really has. And there's just nobody like her. I adore her. I love her. I know that you all love her, and she deserves this honor tonight more than anybody. And she's the greatest. And there's nothing else I can say more except I love you, Adriana Trigiani. I will love you till the day I die. And you so deserve what you are being, what you are getting tonight, and the fact that you are being honored. You should be honored every week. That's all I have to say. So, ladies and gentlemen, your honoree tonight at the National Organization of Italian American Women's 40th Anniversary Gala, Miss Adriana Trigiani.
Where do I begin? I am so deeply honored and so thrilled to be with you for the 40th gala. You know, this didn't come about just out of thin air. It was a dream, really, that Italian American women would, with their collective voices, come together to celebrate really what we come from. And that includes all the women in our lines that never got credit for anything they did. So 40 years ago, Dr. Aileen Riotto Sirey, Geraldine Ferraro, started this group, the National Organization for Italian American Women, based on the need to have a collective voice and come together so that the next generation, which would be me, would benefit from it. And have I been lucky? I came to New York and I knew no one. But always what saved me or what shored me up on some level was this community of Italian Americans. And as you know, I grew up in Appalachia, so we weren't around a lot of Italians. We visit my grandmother in Pennsylvania, or we visit my grandmother in Chisholm, Minnesota. And, you know, I got a sense of what it meant to be Italian to me because they were both women that owned their own businesses, both my grandmother. This was, of course, before we, you know, backslid a little bit after the war, when they really sold us on the idea that a waxy floor would like complete our lives. But we knew there was nothing wrong with a beautiful wax floor. I care about that too. After all, I am Italian. But what I'm trying to share with you is that maybe the previous generation couldn't be lawyers and couldn't be doctors and couldn't be professors, but they made it possible for us to do it. So when you celebrate 40 years, you're really celebrating an eon of advancement. When I got here, I got this newspaper called Backstage and I started going through it. And wouldn't you know that there was an Italian American, it was called the Italian American Playwrights Forum. And I thought, I'm a playwright and I'm Italian American, I'm going over there. And so the first two women that I meet were Rosemary DeAngelis and Donna DiMatteo, the great playwright. And both of them, they were my first Italian American firewall. Later, I met Angelina Fiordalisi, who you have honored in the past. She, too, is a wonder. She's not only a great producer, she's a great actor. And nothing thrilled me more than when I got to make Big Stone Gap, which I was wrote and directed. She starred in it. Are you starting to see what's happening here? There's a lot of people responsible for the reason I get this award and get to wear these ribbons today. And when I got into books, who's waiting at the other side of that, except Len and Louise Riggio and Steve and his beautiful wife. And the books have been incredible because I've gotten to really travel and get to know the Italian-American communities around the country. So that's my story for starters. But now I really want to talk about you. If we were in the setting where we would usually be for the gala, this would be a whole different thing. But this is so great because I can talk directly to you and it's very intimate. So I feel in a sense that I am talking to my sisters and my girlfriends. I'm so lucky because I have
in my life, the waft and weave of Italian American, young Italian American women that come in, you know, hire Italian American women when you have the opportunity. Mentor them, take them seriously. So I want to say one more thing to you before I go, besides my evermore gratitude for everything you did. On behalf of my grandmothers, my mother, my father, my grandparents, I am going to include my grandfathers there. I mean, we know how to do family. So really, I guess my final comment is going to be to celebrate your Italian-American heritage in every way that you can and be involved. 40 years, it's an incredible organization that Aileen and Geraldine started. And I think it's going to be around for maybe 400 more. So thank you. And I'm certainly here and available. Your sister is on hold waiting for you. I look forward to being with you in person. I'm glad we've had this like one-on-one time together. So thank you. Thank you for this honor. It's really one of the great honors of my lifetime, and I am thrilled. God bless you, everyone. And we'll see you when this pandemic is over.
Hi, I'm Lidia Bastianich, chef, restaurateur, cookbook author, host of a cooking show, and an Italian-American woman. And I am so honored to have been asked to introduce one of the recipients of this year's gala. And this year is the 40th anniversary virtual gala of NOIAW, an organization that has been there to support, to back, to help forward, move forward, to subsidize, in a sense, the Italian-American women. And my dear friend is Angelo Vivolo, and he has been a supporter of NOIAW since the beginning, since I can remember. Angelo is an extraordinary human being. He is a successful businessman, a humanitarian, a great father and grandfather. He, for 40 years, ran a successful restaurant business, but within that context, he got involved in his society, in his environment, in his neighborhood, in his culture, in many different ways. As a member of the Columbus Citizen Foundation for over 30 years, he presided as president for 4 years and was the organizer, the general director, if you will, of the Columbus Day Parade for 7 years. During those years that he was capable of bringing together great personalities, Lady Gaga, Il Volo, the Tony Bennett, Barry Manilow, Andrea Bocelli. These are all great names, most of them Italian, Italian-American, and harnessed to support young Italian-American girls and boys, women and men, to support their education. Angelo is all for education. He was a teacher initially. He's on the board of directors of John Cabot University in Rome. He is participates in the support of the Partnership for Inner City Education, the Futures in Education program, and the Child Center in New York. These are all local agencies that help and support young people in their educational conquest, if you will. He is on the advisory board for the New York City College of Technology, the Hotel and Restaurant Management Department. He is also, he has was elected to be the ambassador of the Culinary Institute of America, and he garnered Medal of Honor and was inducted in the International Escoffier Society. Angelo, my dear friend, also, he can't say no to a fundraiser. You know, when he gets asked, or he sees an opportunity that he can do some good, he's there. And we did many causes together. One of the first was Share of Strength. We did it in Lincoln Center with all the restaurants. Then we did UNICEF. UNICEF, we are all familiar with the children's organization. We did the theme of a Roman holiday. And yes, Audrey Hepburn, Gregory Peck, and they were present at the event. Can you imagine? Then he was honored as well from Italy. You know, they recognized his potential and his love for his culture. And he was given the Ufficiale dell'Ordine al Merito della Repubblica Italiana by President Mattarella. And that's a big, big recognition given to Italians and Italian Americans, Italians abroad that have contributed to the betterment of Italy in some way or other. The one thing that's important tonight is that he has been a staunch supporter of NOIA and supported women in our industry. So, my dear friend Angelo, please, all of you, join me in welcoming my dear friend Angelo Vivolo.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Lidia, for your very kind and generous words. We've had a cherished friendship for over 35 years. Can you believe it? It has even been said that I am my dear friend Lydia's adopted brother. How lucky would that be? I'm so grateful for our terrific friendship for so many years. Tonight, I want to congratulate my fellow honorees to be honored on this, the 40th anniversary of NOIA, with Brenda Vaccaro and Adriana Trigiani. I am clearly out of my league with these esteemed and accomplished women. Several years ago, I was asked to introduce at this event a giant in our community, Joe Matone. To be here tonight to receive the same recognition that Joe Matone makes it extra special, and I can't tell you how honored I am. To know that NOIA was founded by Matilda Cuomo, Aileen, Sirey, and the late, great Geraldine Ferrara is inspiring enough. To think 40 years ago, they had the foresight and the determination to celebrate, acknowledge, and support the accomplishments of Italian-American women. Some may call them trailblazers. To me, they were brave, brilliant women with courage and conviction who raised the mark for all women to be heard, recognized, and succeed. They, and so many of you participating in tonight's celebration, have grown this organization to become the leading organization in the country as the vanguard for Italian-American women. I want to thank Maria Tamburri for her excellent leadership and the members of her board for giving me this special honor. For many years, I've been involved with supporting our great Italian heritage and culture in my role as president and chairman of many of the organizations that I'm sure you are familiar with that share many of the same goals as NOIA. I was asked to speak about the most influential women in my life. In addition to my wife, Denise, of 43 years, who is the love of my life and inspires me every day, I must talk about my Sicilian mother. Though I do not think that my experience was unique, my mother's principles resonate with me every day, and I am so thankful for it. Compassion, respect, love of family and God, respect for one another, and compassion to help others, giving without expectations of getting anything in return. She would say that the reward is in the giving. To me, that is what it means to be Italian, and that is what NOIA stands for. I want to congratulate every woman at this event tonight and thank you as a very proud Italian American for all that you do to promote our great heritage and culture. I wish you a heartfelt continued success. Thank you from the bottom of my heart and may God bless you always.
This is a message for my dearest friend Aileen Sari and to all my Italian-American friends. I would say, sister, many of whom I know personally, like Matilda Cuomo, just to name one. I want to congratulate you all for your anniversary. It's wonderful to have the voice of Italian-American women involved in the affairs of the state. A country like the United States of America, a country we all love. Maybe not, we do not support you in all issues, but we both are countries with strong democracy, and we have been and always will be strong allies. We believe that the USA is the greatest country in the world and a great fighter for justice around the world. We must keep on fighting for justice, human rights, equality, and fight against bigotry, intolerance, and discrimination. I had the joy of meeting many of you while you invited me to your celebration for your 20th anniversary. And then, of course, Aileen and Donna Di Matteo came to Australia when we celebrated our 20th anniversary. They also traveled to other Australian cities, from Sydney to Melbourne to Adelaide, to visit other Italian-Australian women organizations. They were a wonderful occasion. I hope that this terrible pandemic will soon be over and we can meet again in Australia or in the USA. We both love Australia and the United States of America, but we will always love also our country of origin, Italy, which is great culture and history. I send you once more my congratulations for your anniversary and all my love. Franca Arena.
The National Organization of Italian American Women is committed to encouraging young women of Italian descent who have achieved academic success to realize their dreams of higher education. Since 1980, NOIA has awarded scholarships annually to deserving women in pursuit of their educational advancement. I remember being struck by NOIA's support of women when I attended my first annual gala. In fact, I was so moved that I endowed a scholarship in honor of my grandmother, Maria Donata Rossetti, and my mother, Margherita Rossetti Monk, two strong Italian-American women who left their mark on me and my extended family. Both were born in Italy in Consano, a tiny little village at the top of a mountain in Abruzzo, where they endured hardships and came to the United States, as so many immigrants did, to start a new life while celebrating and embracing their Italian heritage. Endowing a scholarship in their honor was my way to honor them for all that they have given me and my family, and to celebrate my mother for being the first in her family to go to college. Today, it is my great privilege to introduce you to Gina Gallo Reinhardt, the inaugural recipient of the scholarship in honor of my mother and grandmother. Gina attends the University of Connecticut and is studying for her Ph.D. in Italian Literacy and Cultural Studies. She currently teaches at Bristol Central High School in Bristol, Connecticut, and is the president of the Connecticut Italian Teachers Association. It is my distinct pleasure to introduce you now to Gina Gallo Reinhardt.
Buonasera a tutti e a tutti. Mi chiamo Gina Gallo e vorrei ringraziarvi per questo evento spettacolare. And what an amazing event tonight is. My name is Gina Gallo and I come to you from the lovely state of Connecticut. Welcome to the 40th anniversary virtual gala for the National Organization of Italian American Women. This is such a special event. It is absolutely incredible to be surrounded by such strong, influential women. In today's society, I certainly think we need to take a moment and highlight these incredible women. I was a lucky recipient of a scholarship to help defray the cost of an Italian PhD program at the University of Connecticut. Although this award came in the form of financial aid, I do find it to be so much more. The funds for the scholarship were donated by Rebecca Monk Ricciviano, honoring the memory of her mother, Margherita Rusciti Monk, and her grandmother, Maria Donata Rusciti. What an incredible way to honor one's family. Mothers and grandmothers, are they not the backbone of so much of our lives? And they really, in my experience, they shaped us and me in every way. So it is an honor to represent these women. I hope that in a small way, I'm able to continue their legacy through my teaching and continued education. As a daughter, a granddaughter, and now a mother of my own proud little Italian-American female, I find it so important to maintain ties to our heritage. and the National Organization of Italian American Women offers so many opportunities to grow and connect with our heritage. Just as Rebecca creating a scholarship in honor of her family, I would like to take the opportunity to thank all the amazing Italian American women who have shaped my very rich life. My mother is out there crying somewhere as she watches this, I am sure of that. But all that, my aunts, my cousins, the professors that I've had, these women have shaped so much of who I am and who I am as a person, but also as a teacher. So without them, I would be so much less passionate, so much less cultured. And I really owe so much of what I do on a daily basis to these incredible Italian women. A quick shout out to the committee for all of their hard work in making this virtual gala a reality. I know how hard it is to make connections virtually, and you guys have done such an amazing job putting this together. I wish you all strength and health as this year continues, and I cannot wait to do this faccia faccia nel futuro. I look forward to joining all of your future events. Thank you all for this incredible opportunity, and thank you for giving me this opportunity to continue studying Italian. Un bacione a tutti.
We're proud to present the awardees of the 2021 NOIA Scholarship. Anna Bartoli, endowed by Francesco and Mary Giambelli Foundation. Giovanna Francesca Dana, endowed by Rebecca Monk Risigliano, Esquire. Sarah Davis, endowed by Patricia Martone, Esquire. Tara DiCasio, in memory of founding NOIAW member, the Honorable Geraldine A. Ferraro. Cristina Latino, endowed by Cavaliere Joseph M. Matone and Cavaliere Marianne Matone. Emily Russell, endowed by Luis and Len Riggio. Joellen Spiridelozzi, endowed by the Francesco and Mary Giambelli Foundation. Congratulations to all these inspiring Italian-American young women, and thank you to those who support and mentor them.
Carissime amiche della National Organization of Italian American Women and dear friends, custodian of the Italian heritage in the US and all over the world. I'm happy to send you my best wishes from Rome, my second favorite city in the world. If you promise not to tell my government, I will confess that the first one is New York City. I miss you so much. I miss you, Aileen, Matilda, Angelo, and Lidia, but I miss also the wonderful people you gathered today. I haven't met them yet, but Brenda, Adriana, Mario, and Mo, you are already my friends, since you are the friends of NOIAW. Unfortunately, it's not only my work which keeps me far from you. It is also this terrible pandemic, which caused so many sufferings on both sides of the Atlantic and all over the world. We hope to win the war against COVID-19 very soon, thanks to the vaccines, the cure, and especially the dedication of people in the health sector, especially women, who work hard to protect our health. But I'm not the only one missing you. I'm here with colleagues and friends who spent some time working in New York, and we all want to tell you happy 40th anniversary to NOIA, and see you soon in New York City.
None of this would be possible without the guidance of our National Board of Directors. It is now my privilege to present the distinguished women who govern our organization. They are Pat Tinto, President, Diana Famia, Vice Chair, Dr. Donna Corrado, Treasurer, Dr. Donna Chirico, Secretary, Dr. Mary Rose Barranco Morris, Anne-Marie DiTello, Esquire, Donna De Matteo, Founding Member, Robin Mbimbo, Cavaliere Mary Ann Matone, Cavaliere Angela Mazzarelli, Justice, Professor Gemma Pugliese, Rebecca Monk Risigliano, Esquire, Betty St. Angelo, Esquire, former chair. Maria T. Vulo, Esquire. In closing, we thank you for being part of our 40th anniversary gala, celebrating and empowering Italian American women. Our heartfelt appreciation goes out to our wonderful sponsors. If you're not a member, please consider joining. If you are a member, please renew. Support our next 40-year fund to inspire, connect, and lead Italian American women across the nation. Send us your Italian American woman story and say hello by email in chat. We look forward to seeing you in the months to come. Before we go, let's bring back Dr. Aileen Riotto Sirey for some parting words.
We'll get together at our 50th anniversary.
I am woman, hear me roar, in numbers too big to ignore.
Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum. You came along and everything started into hum. Still, it's a real good bet, the best is yet to come. Best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? You think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. Wait till the warm-up's underway. Wait till our lips have met. Wait till you see that sunshine day. You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? Best is yet to come, come the day you're mine. I'm gonna teach you to fly. We've only tasted the wine. We're gonna drain the cup dry. Wait till your charms are ripe for these arms to surround. You think you've flown before, but baby, you ain't left the ground. Wait till you're locked in my embrace. Wait till I draw you near. Wait till you see that sunshine place. Ain't nothing like it here. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? The best is yet to come, come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. And you're gonna be mine.